Welcome back to another Final Cut Pro tutorial, and today we're going to be talking about color masks and why they're important. Let's show you how they work.
We'll begin by adding an awesome color effect to this sunset footage. First, select your clip in the timeline and position the playhead over it. Then navigate to the effects menu on the right and add the desired effect to the clip. We'll choose Colorize. Then navigate to the inspector on the top right. If the inspector isn't showing, be sure to toggle this icon. And click on this video inspector icon. Navigate to the effects section, and if the controls aren't yet showing, be sure to click Show. Now let's tweak our colorize effect. For this example, we'll remap the black and white to these colors. What does this mean? To put it simply, the darker values in the viewer will be changed to violet, and the lighter colors in the viewer will be changed to pink. So colorize is a great effect to create a duotone or monotone look on your footage.
It's a mental break for you right now, so stand up and stretch and do what you gotta do. And while you're at it, put your little finger down on your mouse and click the like, share, and subscribe button.
Now that colorize is set, it's time to add a color mask to limit our effect to a certain range of colors. To the right of the effect name, click on the Apply Effect Masks icon. And in the pop-up menu, choose Add Color Mask. You'll notice the color mask parameter appears in the effects section. And in the viewer, the cursor will change to an eyedropper tool. Now, drag across the range of colors that you want the colorize effect to apply to. As you drag, the mask will show you the original colors of the clip so that you can choose which of these you want your effect to apply to. Any colors outside the range will be grayed out, and the wider you drag the circle, the more colors will be included in the range. You can drag new selection circles as many times as you'd like. After that, you can fine-tune your selection. Include more colors in your effect mask by holding down the Shift key, positioning the eyedropper on the colors you want to add, and dragging. Or you can subtract colors from the mask by holding the Option key and dragging across a color to remove. And to adjust the sharpness of the color mask edges, drag the softness slider in the inspector. Here are a few more tips to ensure you get the perfect color mask. You can view the mask range by clicking the arrow next to View Masks and choose black and white. The masked area is white. The area around the mask is black. And the transparent areas of the mask are in grayscale. Or click the drop-down again and choose Color to view the mask in color. The mask only applies to the area in color. And the gray indicates the area outside the mask. To return to normal view, click on View Masks again. And if you want to invert the mask, click on the Apply Effect Masks button and choose Invert Masks. With color masks, you'll have precision control over where you want your footage to be affected.
So, whether you're trying to change the color of a shirt or you're trying to change the color of a sky, a color mask will work for you.
Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.
Well, grab your partner, do-si-do, and I'll tell you what you gotta do. You gotta share, subscribe, and comment, and like below.